Hey there.
Hello.
Hi.
Wow.
Anybody else?
Wow.
Anybody else feel like you just got robbed?
Yep.
Okay. What the fuck? Disclaimer.
I missed a lot of the Sony conference.
You came in at the Final Fantasy 15 VR, right?
I came in just after that.
So let's rewind. Because we're talking about all the conferences today. We had...
Let's just start with what's fresh first.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so Sony started with God of War. A, why the fuck is... It seems like they're rebooting slash not rebooting, but it's named God of War. No subtitle, no number. What the fuck? I'm so tired of this. I'm just going to call it Dad of War from now on, because that's what I got from it. And God of War was released on the PS2, so, yeah. And then we had, after that was Days Gone. Oh yeah, and Dad of War looked nothing like a God of War game. Nothing like a God of War game. What the fuck?
It actually reminded me of, what's it called? The latest Far Cry game, Far Cry Primal.
Yeah.
And the orchestra and the five screen during the quote. Live gameplay.
That five screen
was very distracting.
Pissed me the fuck off. I was, oh my god. I'm glad it only showed up twice, but that it showed up at all is infuriating. After that was Days Gone. There was just a cinematic trailer, which we saw the gameplay for afterwards. Quote unquote gameplay. There was no UI. I highly doubt that was actual game.
Yeah.
After that, Last Guardian, I can't bring myself to care about this game anymore. It's been way too long. It looks way too outdated. Shadow of the Colossus is one of my favorite games of all time. But
that hype train's come and gone.
Yeah. I'm going to play it when it comes out, but I'm not sitting here waiting on bated breath. After that, Detroit, which seemed really fucking interesting.
Too nice for it to actually be Detroit, though.
Well, yeah. Futuristic replicant kind of thing. It seems like it's going to be the age-old moral dilemma of, are androids actually people?
No.
After that was the Resident Evil 7 Biohazard VR. That looked pretty great. At first, I was groaning because, oh my god, a Silent Hills knockoff. But I think this is the only thing the Resident Evil franchise can do to stay relevant.
Pretty much.
And the fact that it's VR, that's great. It's coming from the guys who made Kitchen, which was scary as shit. Let's see. Last Guardian is coming out October 25th. Resident Evil 7 is coming out January 24th of next year. PlayStation VR launches on October 13th. Then Batman VR. And it just said October. They didn't show us anything. It was just some Mark Hamill lines, I'm assuming.
Battlefront VR.
Let's see. Then there was Final Fantasy 15. Which we already got the release date during the Xbox conference. So September 30th. Final Fantasy 15 VR, which is pointless and fucking stupid. Where did the Star Wars VR fit in?
It was like right between Batman and Final Fantasy, I believe.
I didn't type it down because
didn't give a shit.
It didn't say or give us anything.
Battlefront was just a bad game. Let's move on.
Right. Infinite Warfare. Holy shit!
Yeah, that game. Holy crap.
Holy
yeah, I'll be
shit.
Honest. As soon as that popped up, I recognized immediately the design in it. I could tell. This
as
is
soon
Infinite
as the
Warfare.
UI came up, I was
good.
Like, oh.
It looked good.
Oh, yeah.
I'll say it right now. It looks good. The video that was shown on YouTube still sucked ass, I think. But now that we actually see the game, we see what it's about, we see the pacing, we get a better picture of the game we're going to get.
I just love how they work the grappling hooks into the kills.
Oh, I somehow I skipped over Horizon Zero Dawn. Holy shit, that looked great.
Yeah. Game I haven't followed too closely, but it impressed.
See, yeah, Crash Remastered. That's good to see. Like, a lot of people are getting sick of remasters. I just think they need to pick the right ones, and this is a case that they picked the right one.
Yeah, I mean, remasters are getting a bit high in quantity, but there's quite a few good remasters coming out lately.
There was... After that, the Lego Star Wars game. It's Lego Star Wars.
You know what? Sure.
I love Lego games, so I'm all for it.
I mean, you know, the other Lego Star Wars games, you know, I know friends that, you know, I have kids and they play with them, and it's a good game because it has a lot of stuff for the adults to get into, and, you know, whatever.
It's got its charm.
There was Death Stranding, that Kojima one that didn't show us a goddamn thing.
That was a really weird one.
It was just for him to say, I've got something else.
Ghost Baby.
Yeah, Ghost Baby. Ghost Baby and,
Naked Reedus.
Yeah, Ghost Baby and Naked Reedus. After that, it was Spider-Man!
I can go for a new Spider-Man IP, and it's from Insomniac.
Yeah, exactly. Spider-Man from Insomniac. Fuck yes.
Let's see, what came after that? Oh, the Crash reveal for Skylanders? I think that's completely misplaced. Like, I'm really glad they're remastering the older Crash, you know, Bandicoot games for PS4. But at the same time, I think putting Crash Bandicoot in Skylanders is dumb because nobody from the, you know, the generation that would play Skylanders would even know what Crash Bandicoot is.
They're probably banking on them buying it and then getting into the franchise and then adding it to their Skylander collection.
But for me personally, they tried building Crash as a mascot for Sony at one point. He shouldn't be coming back and getting rammed into Skylanders. He should have his own new game.
There he is. Other than Spider-Man, was like... Oh, and then they showed the game, the quote-unquote gameplay for Days Gone, which I'll believe it when I have it in my hands.
I'm not going to call that data. Actually, when we were watching it, did it have a UI at all?
No.
So, no.
There was no UI at all.
That was it.
Okay, just for the record then, you know, we're all in agreement. We are not counting that as actual gameplay. We just got Colonial Marined.
That was far too scripted. Can't tell me that ending wasn't so.
Well, every time he stopped to shoot the damn zombie, it's like, why? I would keep running.
And,
yeah, and that ending was a bit strange too, to be surrounded completely like that.
They didn't show. I'm surprised we didn't see any Destiny.
Kingdom Hearts.
We didn't see any Kingdom Hearts 3. Kingdom Hearts 3, I wasn't sure if it was going to be there, but I was positive we were going to see the Destiny stuff.
What about Star Ocean?
Huh?
Star Ocean.
That's
They're
right.
Supposed to be making a new game.
And Shenmue.
No, Star Ocean?
And then Shenmue. They could have said something about that.
Yeah.
All in all, this was a very short conference. It was like getting choke slammed by a midget.
It wasn't short. It was, there was a lot in there. And it was, let's talk more game. It was just, there was no good game to show.
Yeah.
So maybe it's a lack of actual context. There's a lot going on, but no real context to it all. You know, we didn't see anything about No Man's Sky either.
Well,
that's supposed to release, like, you know, here pretty soon.
That's true.
Like, really soon.
Here's funny, you know how they were talking, because I still have the window open. They're talking, oh, we're gonna have all this great stuff after the broadcast. Dead. There's nothing that's offline.
So yeah, that was an extremely disappointing conference.
Yeah.
Barring in mind that I've yet to see the EA one, worst one I've seen so far. When Ubisoft, which is the one I expected to be terrible, outdoes you, you have a problem.
Yeah, so that was Sony's conference. And then, rewinding back, we've got Ubisoft's. And that one I'll have to go off of memory. I didn't actually take notes for that one. So they started with a weird Just Dance number. We can just skip over that. What do they show after that?
One second.
I think it was the South Park announcement after that, wasn't it?
No, yes. that was a little later, wasn't it?
No, they
went straight into Wildlands.
Yes, Wildlands.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, they went straight into Ghost Recon right from the start.
Yeah.
Right after Just Dance.
Yeah, Wildlands looks fantastic. It looks exactly like Mercenaries was supposed to be like.
That's immediately what I thought of. When I thought of the setting, I was like, oh, this is Mercenaries. But I was like, okay, I like, you know, four-player co-op.
Yeah.
You know, maybe, you know, it has that real open world setting to it where you can really do things how you want.
Yeah, it's an open world, so on and so forth, which I just hope this isn't the standard copy-paste open world that Ubisoft likes to do, where it's more substance over style.
Climbing towers, doing side activities, yeah.
And that, and like, you could have a giant box, and you unwrap it thinking, oh my god, this is going to be a great present, and you got, you know, a battery in there. Like,
not you got a turd.
Like, open world games have this problem of, like, hey, we're huge! Like, okay, but what's in your world?
And
I don't care how
big
the world is if there's nothing in it. But, I don't know. So we'll see if that becomes a problem in the game. It looks like it's teetering that line.
It was... what we saw, I enjoyed. And I look forward to blowing shit up.
I think Assassin's Creed was next, I believe.
Assassin's Creed was way later.
The movie.
South Park was next.
Yeah, South Park with that fake the fake out trailer. That was great.
You know what? Let us actually give credence to Matt and Trey Parker for what they brought us with Shattered Butthole.
Oh, yeah.
They gave us probably one of the best introductions and showings of their game for all of E3.
Oh yeah, that was fantastic. Like, the bait and switch trailer. Everybody, even on Twitter, thought it was gonna be the fucking Purge. But even just like the game itself, what they showed off looks great. Adds some added mechanics. It looks a little bit more of the same, but the same is great. So I'm happy with more of the same.
Yes.
I'm really excited about that.
There's more classes, so to put it, and you can mix powers from the different ones in this one.
Yeah, that and the whole the whole Marvel dick that they had. Like, he gets his own
just
movie.
Marvel.
Well, yeah, they threw DC in there.
They also had the DC digs,
but they were really digging into Marvel.
Oh no! Did you hear? I think it was Stan. I was like, let's just do it all. You know, all of us in each one. And, we'll be like, I was like, dig at DC. It was great. Like, they said DC Comics. It was
Yeah.
You don't even get the first phase DC Comics.
that was pretty great. But, apparently a lot of people were angry about them for pointing out the whole Black Panther thing. His token, his superhero is getting a movie in Phase 3. Like, he gets a movie, but yeah, not until Phase 3.
But, you know, that's what's great about South Park. That's what South Park's great about.
Exactly.
It's supposed to be a giant fucking joke.
They're very good at prodding on topical humor. It's not always, it can be hit or miss, but they're very good about addressing it.
Usually it's a hit.
Yeah, usually.
And we have a date.
Let's see.
December 6th, right?
Yep, December 6th.
Yeah.
And any pre-orders comes with the Stick of Truth, so if you haven't played it.
That's only if you pre-order it soon, I believe, within this month?
Possibly.
Something like
maybe.
That. I was looking through the Ubisoft store at the different versions of the Shattered Butthole release, and there's a standard gold, then there's the further collector's editions and scrap. There's like six editions.
Damn, it's typical weird. Ubisoft like, fashion.
Yeah, the big collector's editions come with a Cartman statue.
Okay, I need it.
I was like, I don't know.
I'm just gonna go order it right now.
I don't know. I mean, yeah, maybe. It wasn't cheap.
No.
But, yeah, I mean, it looks like they really amped it up with how they want to play the game, how they want the game to play. They completely changed the dynamic of the entire gameplay.
Oh, no.
What's up?
Season pass for it.
Yeah.
It depends on what they're putting in it, really.
Yeah.
It was just cosmetic items last time. But you know what? Fuck it. I liked, like, even the cosmetic items I got for The Secret Truth, I liked. I mean, he's like, okay, whatever.
Yeah, I mean, I played a Jew in Samurai and called him the Jumurai.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, it's a 6-inch Coon figurine. I love it.
But yeah, if you, you know, going back to the actual gameplay of Shattered Butthole, and we got to, you know, I love saying that, by the way. And, and we got to see that it's, it looks, okay, it's going to be turn-based, but it's tile-based. So we're getting a completely different type of game now. Different abilities, different effects. It's going to be interesting.
It looked like they're taking a tactics approach to it.
Back to Infinite Warfare really quick. Apparently, if you pre-purchase Special Edition on PS4, you get the Modern Warfare campaign 30 days early.
Oh, yeah, they showed that on screen.
Oh, I didn't see that. Whoops.
Oh, wow, how much is that going to be?
I think it was like 89 or something.
I was looking at the collector's for the other game.
I still think they should have done the MW4 remaster as a standalone rather than a bullshit tie-in.
So, they didn't show anything about the Neo at the conference either, which, major mistake. Major mistake.
Yeah.
No, they kept playing around with it. Like, in, what was it, in Final Fantasy 15?
Yeah.
They were like, here's the Neo.
Yeah.
Like, I'm wearing it in-game.
But
Xbox,
okay. That was,
Xbox had a better
PSVR
conference. Sony had more titles.
Well, let's stick to one conference at a time, because we're still talking about Ubisoft, and there's a lot more to go over.
Yes.
It's best not to get it all mixed up, that way Jayson can actually edit it.
This is going to all go together. I just was talking about one at a time to get flow going.
Yeah.
So, we've got, okay, so, South Park, what was after that?
Division DLCs.
What was after that? We don't care.
Well, the showstopper was, what was it?
Eagle Flight?
That was at the end, though. What?
It was Eagle Flight.
Oh, yeah, the VR first-person, like, Eagle three-person, or team, whatever. Yeah, that thing.
And they're screeching at each other.
That screeching get annoying fast. Like, wow. But aside from that, it looks pretty cool.
Looks interesting.
It's good to see, you know, VR taking off, whatever.
Move on.
What was the snowboarding game at the end?
That was Steep.
I am actually, like, back when I got into Trials Fusion for the first time, that's the kind of feeling I got from that game. Just unadulterated, pure fun.
Yeah, it just looks like pure fun, and I'm so excited for it.
It
Holy
looks like
shit.
It has a lack of boundaries as well. Like, you're in a region, you do whatever the fuck you want.
Most painful wipeout competition coming your way.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I
the wipeouts. The dude in the wingsuit hitting the bell. Dung!
I lost my shit when that happened.
It was so great.
I would love to go in there and actually plan races, like the most treacherous race you could. And then, and yeah, that'd be great. Make some funny stuff.
No, we skipped over it.
Yeah, we skipped over a few things, but
Jayson about orgasm.
Trials, I keep forgetting the title.
Blood Dragon.
Trials of the Blood Dragon, yeah. That's interesting. They're like, hey, oh, by the way, it's out today. Oh, okay. Well, they did that last year with the Trials Fusion DLC, didn't they? The Awesome Level Max?
Yeah, they did.
That was a surprise announcement.
I'll be honest, I wasn't overly impressed with the Trials of the Blood Dragon. The thing that got me was, it's out now. That's
what really got me about it. It looked cool. I think I'll have fun with it.
Man, the greatest thing about Trials is the fact that it has so much customizability in their player-created maps. Like, Red Links. Their maps, like, if you were watching what they were showing, is they had, like, you know, isometric, you know, FPS and all this other crap that players went in and they made with the in-game map creator.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what Snap Map for Doom was trying to be. It's got a long way to go.
Wow, I'm... What?
What's up?
I'm looking at Twitter, and apparently everybody's raving about how PlayStation had the best E3 conference. Like, what?
They're stupid.
They had the second worst one.
Idiots.
No, this is coming from, like, Jim Sterling, Jesse Cox, Angry Joe, like, everybody. What?
No, they didn't have the best conference.
Sorry.
I don't know. Angry Joe didn't say they had the best conference. He said that Sony killed it, but I must admit, I actually bought something immediately after the Microsoft conference.
All those people who said that just lost a ton of credibility.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much a tie-up at this point between Ubisoft and Bethesda, but I'm pretty sure Bethesda still won anyway.
I don't know. I gotta say, Bethesda, Microsoft, Sony so far are the ones I've actually watched.
Like, Jeff Sterling said this about Bethesda, and I have to agree, where he was saying, they couldn't top last year's, because last year they hadn't done anything before. They came in and said, hey, I have a giant dick, and then threw it on the table with a giant thud. And we went, okay, that's a huge dick. Now, cut to this year, they still got that giant dick. It's just, we've seen the dick before. We still appreciate the dick. It's still a great dick. But, it's just... The surprise of it is not there.
Not to mention last year, like, they didn't have any technical issues at all, and this time they had a couple of times where
everyone had technical issues this year.
Yeah.
I think that was probably the Twitch side of things.
The Wildland frame squeeze part was hilarious.
What else was shown at Ubisoft's?
Watch Dogs.
Star Trek VR.
Yeah.
Star Trek VR, yes. That looked awesome.
Yeah, I'll actually admit, I really enjoyed seeing the older actors getting on there.
Yeah.
And really showcasing what it is. And I had fun watching that. And then, so I would, you know, if I had a VR, which I won't for a while, I will, I would be interested in playing it.
I'm working on it.
How do you guys feel about the game, the actual gameplay itself, though? Like, because we got to see some of the menus. You know, we didn't really get to see the actual effects of anything, though.
Right, but I think it's more geared towards people who just want to kind of roleplay in that. The people who will totally nerdgasm over it, like myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Be sitting there on the bridge with some friends, like, we're piloting a ship right now.
And also,
guys, we're piloting the Enterprise.
Let's see. It was that. I mentioned Steep again because, oh my god, I'm so excited for Steep.
There's also Grow Up, too.
Oh, yeah, Grow Up, which Grow Home was great, so I'm happy to see that it's getting a continuation or whatever.
For Honor, of course.
Oh, yes, for Honor. I didn't realize they were going to be doing a campaign with it.
Neither did I. I assumed it was on multiplayer.
That looks really good. Like, especially the mechanics where he threw him into the spikes on the wall. That was awesome.
I also like we got to see kind of how the blocking system works.
Yeah, well, they showed more UI than they did on the last one. I mean, I've gotten to play it, but it's NDA, so.
as of now, until I see more people smashing their faces open in Steam. Out of that press conference, I have to say For Honor was the one I was most hyped for.
Yeah, For Honor looked fantastic. Was there anything else from that conference?
Watch Dogs 2.
Watch Dogs 2, yeah. It looks good. I'm not allowing myself to get excited for it. But
yeah, I'm anticipating really it. Cautious.
My level of skepticism is on a new high.
Oh yeah, I'm extremely skeptic, but at the same time, I'm looking forward to seeing whether it delivers on that or not.
I think the thing I'm sort of concerned about is they turned DedSec into this like mysterious organization to like a front lines assault that's like out there chasing after people like crazy. I don't know if I necessarily like that.
I'd say it was more of a guerrilla combat group.
Yeah. I mean, we'll have to see how it's actually represented in the game. They do seem like, oh my god, we're teen edgelords. But we'll see how it plays out. That fucking mask! I want that goddamn mask!
Oh yeah, that mask was great.
Yeah. That was definitely a level of stuff that I want.
Was We've Happy Few, was that a Ubisoft thing or was
Xbox.
That
That was Xbox.
Yeah, that was Xbox, yeah.
Are we done with Ubisoft?
We still want to talk about the Assassin's Creed movie?
No.
I'm looking forward to it. Movie? Doesn't belong at E3. Even the idea of a Watch Dogs movie.
And that's done. That's all we got to say.
Yeah, okay. Ubisoft. So, Microsoft.
Also, one second.
Oh,
whoa,
yeah.
Whoa. If we're working backwards.
Don't run over me.
What's up?
On the club right now, you can get Prince of Persia's Sands of Time for free.
Huh.
Not something they mentioned, but I saw it when I was on the launcher, so I figured to let y'all know.
That's good.
Fair enough. But, let's see, if we're working backwards, let's,
Oh, yeah, PC gaming.
Yeah.
I forgot
Which
about it because...
got interrupted.
Let's just talk about what we actually remember.
Yeah.
Because I zoned out.
I was gonna say, let's just talk about the standouts. There was Mount Blade 2.
No, let's start from the beginning. Dawn of War 3.
Oh, Dawn of War 3.
Which was excellent. They had a fucking space marine walk out with them.
Yeah, that was pretty cool. They had Mount Blade 2. They had...
It looked okay. I saw a destructible environment, so I was like, okay.
Yeah. I mean, I don't like Mount Blade, so...
I would have thought, like, other games like Dead by Daylight and stuff would be there, though.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised. They weren't. Yeah, they showed off the VR backpack, but didn't show off anything VR.
Which, honestly, I think that's just... That's like a gimmick.
Yeah, that's stupid
and
gimmick.
Idea, honestly.
Would you really want to walk outside with that thing?
Well, it's mainly for, like, not wanting to be tethered to your computer for a large room.
Yeah, but we'll probably get wireless signals eventually for that.
No, I mean, I wouldn't want to walk outside with something that expensive.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely true.
That thing is, like, hugely expensive.
They shut off the new hardware, too, the R9 480.
Yeah. Which, okay. I mean, it's a much cheaper alternative if you want to be VR-ready and do it for much cheaper. It's obviously not going to be as powerful as some of the NVIDIA GPUs, but I guess more bang for your buck.
Yeah,
you just have a less potential to bang.
It's going to pretty much be down to whether or not you want to have better performance or price. I mean, it's pretty much going to be the same price as the PSVR and Razer VR, so.
Lawbreakers?
Lawbreakers. Or no, it wasn't Lawbreakers they showed up. Oh, yeah, they did show off Lawbreakers. That's right. That looks great. It looks like a mix of, like, Overwatch-style, you know, here, combat, whatever, with, like, Unreal Tournament.
Whoa! I'm also reading back a little bit, seeing some things that I missed. Vampire, from the makers of Life is Strange.
Yeah, Vampire.
Vampire.
Souls.
Yeah, it looked very Souls-ish.
There's other games too. I mean, this is why we need to take actual notes.
Serious Sam VR.
Yes.
Yeah, that was actually being talked about all morning. And I'm guessing, you know, Jayson here missed it. But they were talking about it all morning. So,
Oxygen not included. We didn't get to see much of that, but it looks interesting.
That's by the team that made Don't Starve.
Yep.
So, and then there was... No, okay, never mind. That was a different conference.
Ark Survival, they talked about that too with the cities that you can build on the new dinosaur.
Oh, which, yeah. I've heard that coming down the pipeline for a while, but yeah, okay, whatever. You know, more stuff for a game. That's cool.
I know you love Killing Floor 2, and you're going to hate what I have to say, but fuck those guys. Stop announcing content packs until you actually release your game.
No, like, I mean, does somebody in here love Killing Floor 2?
Digs.
No, I mean, if you love Killing Floor, I'd understand Killing Floor 2 isn't really a game yet. It's in progress.
The way it's branded is what I hate. Like, they need to stop calling it content packs and whatever. Like they could say we've added these features, we've added these classes, but they're not content packs because you haven't finished the content. So it's you're adding to what comes in the base game.
You're complete. That is what you're saying. But they're trying to act like it is.
Arguably now, with this pack, I would personally consider the game complete. We have the final class, we have the bosses in rotation, we have the maps and everything's in there.
It's actually coming out soon, so. But,
yeah, they actually gave
it. I am, back to Ark, I am so fucking sick of early access survival horror. Sandbox crafting games.
But you know what? You know what? On that note,
Ark looks like the standout of them. But...
Well, actually, no. What I have to say, Ark is just, different and special because actual fucking dinosaur and community shit. Okay. But what I was trying to say is that 7 Days to Die is releasing soon. Like, completely, fully releasing here fairly soon.
Yeah. Like,
and I'm...
I don't know. I'm tired of hearing about Ark. I'm looking forward to playing it once it comes out. I'm not going to touch a damn thing about it until it comes out because I'm so sick of that goddamn genre being all early access.
Yeah, the only one that I've ever seen that was anywhere remotely interesting was Subnautica, and nobody ever talks about that game.
I don't know if you asked about it, I'd tell you about it. Go on, ask me about Subnautica.
Well, I mean, I've seen it. I played it. It's pretty good. I like it a
damn.
Lot.
I was just going to tell you this real quick. It's good.
Yeah, it is good.
It's good.
It's completely underappreciated, in my opinion.
Yep. It has underwater base building. It has really interesting creatures. It has research. It has actual survival elements that are really harsh.
Yeah. It's also made by the same studio that made Natural Selection 2, which was a good game.
But, okay, back on track. Let's see, where were we?
I need to interject. You guys said coming soon for that pack. It's out already.
Yeah, we know.
It right during the middle of it. Jayson
said coming soon. We were just talking
about... No, I was just talking about the content packs in general.
Yeah, we didn't talk about dates or anything. We already know it's out. Because they said at the conference.
Yeah, he did the fucking phone thing that was pointless.
Yeah, that was kind
of... Oh, and VR version. Killing Floor.
Yeah, super hot.
Doing super hot,
VR,
yeah.
Super hot.
Actually,
I care about the Killing Floor one. I do not.
I want to bring something up about the super hot playthrough. Do you remember at the end of it where they took off the helmet?
Uh-huh.
And I actually didn't play it.
It was still in CGI.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really interested in what that really means.
I'm assuming that it goes along with what the first super hot was, which I'm not going to spoil. I don't. But it seems very much in the vein of super hot. So that makes me happy.
Well, being that you're actually playing super hot, I would suppose so.
Anything
I love the fisticuffs, though. That was great.
Yeah, that was great when you saw the fisticuffs.
Not. he just knocked him in the face, and
that was great.
It looked like it had real impact.
Yeah.
The chin.
Tyranny.
Tyranny?
The game from Obsidian where you actually play as the
Obsidian.
Yeah.
You're the villain, sort of.
The asymmetric RPG. Yeah, that looks pretty great. I always love being the villain.
It was an isometric type game. It looked interesting. Obsidian has been talking it up for a little while. I've been checking in on that every now and then, but it looks decent. And Obsidian has been knocking it out of the park recently with other games of that type, like Pillars of Eternity. So they got a lot of experience under their belt to really push this forward.
Okay, so Resident Evil 7 is not only VR.
Well, I hope so.
It's getting a VR mode for PS4, and the demo is out right now on PS4.
If it was only VR, that game would flop.
Yeah, it would. There is a cyberpunk horror game, The Observer.
Oh, yeah, that too. That looked interesting.
Yeah, it's actually by the same people that made Layers of Fear, which is kind of interesting.
Oh, and then there was another a Souls-type game. I don't remember which conference it was in, but it was, futuristic.
Oh, yeah, that was in the PC one as well. I forget what it's called. That one interests me as well, but I gotta see.
Observer?
Observer, no.
Yeah. No, that's a survival horror one. We're talking about the Souls-style game.
They even name drop Souls.
No, Vampyr is the vampire one.
This is the one that even name drops Souls, and it's futuristic.
You're gonna have to look through the footage again and find the name.
Yeah, because I don't remember that one.
Next time we do this, we have to actually take notes.
I was trying to take it during the last Sony conference, but I kept getting distracted by the actual show.
Well, to be fair, the PC Gamer one was one cut off and two moved very fast.
Yeah.
And even then, they got cut off at the end.
Shall we move on to the Microsoft conference?
Well, you know what? Actually, I want to bring that up real quick. They fucked up the scheduling so damn bad, and they didn't even let them finish. They cut
the PC gaming section off. I almost missed the beginning of the PC gaming section because they had their fucking time wrong. Like, oh my god. That was a mess.
Yeah, it was.
So this is cutting off the fucking PC gaming section. So we don't know if there was anything else.
Yeah, I'll have to go back and watch the rest of it.
Okay, but if that's all for that, then I guess we'll move on to the Microsoft section, if you guys are okay with that.
Yeah, Microsoft. So, came out the gate swinging with the Xbox One S.
Oh, wait, whoops, sorry. Ignore me. I really like the Quake.
Me too. But, yes, the Xbox One S, which, wow, actually, like, I'm actually impressed. Like, I didn't think it would be that much smaller.
Yeah, it's interesting. Apparently, they're also going to have four versions of it too, with three varying hard drive size.
Three. It's 500 gig, 1 terabyte, 2 terabyte, 300, right, 350, okay, and 400 respectively. Now we're going to have essentially, not including any like special editions and stuff, we'll have six Xbox Ones. Three of the S's, two of the regulars, and one of the Project Scorpion.
Yeah, but it's also a question, too, if they're going to continue making the regular Xbox, or they're just going to move to Slim only and sell off the remaining amounts.
Well, actually, the S comes out in pretty damn soon.
Yeah.
Yeah, the 2 terabyte comes out in August. The 1 terabyte and 500 gigabyte come out in December of this year. I don't know why the tiered release.
Yeah, it's really weird.
Try to get the money out of the early adopters for the extra $100 that wouldn't have to spend otherwise, and to get the cheaper one out near Christmas time to say, hey, buy this for your kids.
Yeah, I was just like when they wanted to wait on the Kinectless Xbox One.
I'm in no hurry to get it. But if you know, I'll probably end up picking up a Xbox One S, the 500 gigabytes. And then I'm definitely going to consider getting the Scorpio version when that releases in a year and a half.
Yeah.
Maybe. You know,
I get why talked about it, but they didn't need to make such a big presentation out of it. Like,
yeah, especially since they didn't actually show the unit itself.
Yeah.
Well, they definitely needed to confirm it, though.
Yeah, they needed to confirm it. That's all that they needed to do. They didn't need that giant presentation of it, of, you know, them, like, 5-10 minutes of gobbling on their own cock.
they really did a good job of it, though.
Kidding.
But, okay, what does it actually mean, though? What does 6 teraflops actually mean?
Really, the easiest way is to compare it. It's essentially about as powerful as the 970.
Which, more or less.
Yeah, more or less.
For a console, that's fair.
For a console, that's
big. What were they saying about cores? It was like 8 cores or something?
Yeah, they were saying 8 PC cores. So yeah, it's an 8-core machine.
What kind of core?
That's all they said was 8 cores.
Yeah, they don't really specify all that much. I do want to point out, though, they said that there was going to be 320 gigabytes of memory bandwidth. That is not a lot in these days.
Well, yeah, especially by, you know, a year and a half from now, that's going to be outdated.
Like, yeah, because HBM is already proven to be almost as high as 1 terabyte per second now. It's pretty insane.
Yeah, so...
No, we got a year and a half till then, so yeah. They still have time to make changes.
Yeah, we might see some changes in... Or specifications.
We might see those changes in Scorpio, even. Who knows?
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Like, you know, year and a half out. That's plenty of time to change everything.
Yeah. So after that, they came out with Gears, which it looks okay.
New enemy type, I guess. I'm still really confused on what the hell they were talking about. The swarm. It was the fucking tornado.
Really interesting. Yeah.
I like the lightning effects. That was cool.
Yeah, the lightning stuff was cool. I was intrigued by it. Nothing about it said, I need this now, give it to me. But it's one of those, I saw it and went, okay, I'll have fun with this. So. But nothing about it really wowed me.
No, wait. What sold the game to me immediately, though, was the pun and the chainsaw kick off the edge.
Wait, which pun?
No, I can't remember exactly what she said. But, she stuck the chainsaw in the back of the damn...
Oh, yeah.
Whatever it was. And then she said something, and then she lit it up, and he launched off the edge.
Yeah.
It was great.
Horde mode is back, so that's good. I enjoyed that from...
That's a big part of, you know, Gears, though, is the Horde mode.
Yeah. But yeah, nothing about it said I need it now, but I saw it and went, okay, this will be fun when I get to play.
It was very potent for a title.
Yeah.
After that, Forza Horizon 3. Wow.
Looked good.
I was impressed. I'm looking forward to playing it.
If you have been thinking about getting into racing games, this would be a good one.
Absolutely.
I think the best thing about that actually was probably the fact that you can seamlessly go into multiplayer without
having to do anything. Exactly, the seamless joining your friends.
That's pretty crazy.
That was pretty fantastic. And they were showing John Carmack, or no, he wasn't there yet. They were showing one person on the racing wheel, one person on PC, and one person on console, right?
There was actually there was one on console, one using a racing wheel on PC, and then just one using a controller on PC.
Let's not forget, it's exclusively on the Xbox One.
Xbox
One. And Windows 10.
And it's also cross-play.
You might as well address it before we get too far into it. Holy fuck, was that annoying.
Yes, that was very annoying.
I was going through the footage earlier, and one game had it 4 fucking times. The voice announcement at the beginning, a little banner that said the thing about the, what are they calling it? What's it called? When you buy it on Xbox One, you get it for...
Play Anywhere.
Play anywhere. Play anywhere.
The play anywhere thing, and then two more times it said exclusive to Xbox One and Windows 10. I'm like, holy shit!
You know, all they had to do was they only had to. It didn't. We don't need the voice announcement. All they had to do is say at the beginning of the trailer or whatever the showing of it, and that's it. That's all you need to do that one time for contractual obligations. You know, for legal, right? You know, shit.
Total count at the end of that conference, it was mentioned 19 fucking times.
God damn it. Is that counting all of the banners?
Yes.
Wow.
Okay. 19. Felt
like four times that.
Like, when we were watching it on video and stuff, and somebody had mentioned about how it was like up to about 7 or so. No, we were at 15 by that point. I had missed a lot. That was bad. Like, yeah. I love the idea of Play Anywhere. That's fucking great. Buy it on Xbox One and get it on Windows 10 as well. As long as we're not stuck to UWP, which it probably will be, and that is terrible.
Well, here's the thing. Because of UWP is the way it is, and people are already crying for its blood right now, just they want it to die.
Here's
Xbox is going to have to respond to that.
I think I'm all for the death of UWP, but I'm also all for the life of it, and it fixes it fucking self. As to where, like, Steam was a terrible platform when it debuted, but now it's the god of PC.
Just like how Origin was just terrible at first.
And now it's just kind of bad.
Yeah. No.
It's actually pretty good.
In some cases,
they're actually quite often their customer support is by far better than Steam.
Oh yeah, I'm just talking about the program itself and the platform.
Customer support, so.
But yeah. So that Play Anywhere is cool. I just hope they either UWP gets fucked or it gets fixed. One or the other.
Well, they need to unrestrict it.
Yeah. Big time.
I'm just, I'm kind of glad that Microsoft is actually promoting cross-platform play, though. That's an interesting play by them, considering how they really wanted people to get on Windows 10 like crazy.
Yeah. I mean, this is a big way for them to push Windows 10 as well as UWP. Hey, what's going on, Pete?
Hey, Pete.
What was after that? New character for Killer Instinct. I don't give a fuck.
Ram.
It looked cool.
I mean, it looked cool, but Killer Instinct isn't that great. So, like, the original is awesome. The new Xbox One is a taint to its name. What was after that? There's quite a bit of
Titanfall 2, I think.
Did they show Titanfall? They didn't show Titanfall 2 at Xbox, did they?
No, they didn't. They showed Battlefield.
The same trailer we already saw.
Yeah.
I want to comment on that. I think I want to blame EA for that shit because they probably submitted the footage to Xbox. And,
oh yeah, hey, this no, is what we would like to show for. That is completely on EA because look at say last year with Activision having their own whatever deal, and they showed off some Call of Duty gameplay, and then at the PlayStation when they showed off different Call of Duty stuff. Oh! Magic! We don't want to see the same goddamn trailer twice in a row. If we do, we'll go to YouTube.
You see, this is why I don't understand, you know, people's retarded picking a winner in E3. Because it doesn't matter. The winner is always gamers. That's how it's supposed to be.
I was going to say, we're all losers.
There are very notable losers. EA. I'm not even going to hide it.
They fucked it this year.
They fucked us over.
They fucked it this year.
They fucked us over.
Honestly, I think it's just because they don't care. They're like, we're not doing EA next or E3 next year anyway, so fuck this place.
Yeah, it definitely had that feeling to it.
It seemed very contemptful. What was after that?
Minecraft update, I think.
That was pretty cool. The interconnectivity of all of it, being able to not only play from iPad to Surface to Xbox, but to also unlock your Xbox achievements on iPad. That's actually pretty big.
Oh, and mod support those platforms.
Add-ons.
Yeah.
Mod support.
I'll believe it as mod support when I see, like, you know, Thaumcraft and the big mods in there. These just seem like skin packs and that kind of thing.
Like Technic and stuff like that would be pretty cool to see.
Yeah.
It's important to point out also the cross-platform does not apply to the original Minecraft, just the Windows 10 version.
Yes, the Windows 10 version.
And if that's UWP, we don't know if that's going to be moddable or not, and it probably won't be.
Yeah, we'll have to see. Ugh. Which, that's a whole different discussion for a different time. The VR looked really good for Minecraft, though. And he was playing the Pocket Edition on the fucking Gear VR.
Which is pretty cool.
Oh, what's it? Was it the Pocket Edition?
It was the Pocket Edition on Gear VR.
Wow, that was...
Yeah. That was pretty impressive, although, man, there was so much cringe of that. Just in the Minecraft part alone.
Yeah. The fact that they showed that, what was her name, like Minecraft chick or something?
And then friggin' John Carmack coming in like he's Kramer from Seinfeld. Yeah. Like, they should have just had a door for him to burst through just to add to it.
Complete with the beat.
So, what else did they show after that?
Dead Rising 4.
Dead Rising 4.
It looked good.
It did.
I'm glad they're bringing back Frank West, I'm just saying.
From what I understand, it's a remake plus expansion upon the first.
Oh, that's good.
That's kind of weird, but...
Yeah, like, it's a remake, but there's more to it, and it's four-player co-op.
Oh, shit. I'm actually interested in.
Yes.
You know, State of Decay 2.
Yes, State of Decay 2. Yeah,
that game was really good.
At first, it seemed like another just generic zombie game.
Well, I could tell right from the start what it was, because I played quite a bit of State of Decay. The problem with State of Decay when it first came out on Xbox 360 Arcade was we had this idea in our heads. Like, they didn't, try to break that illusion or anything.
Yeah.
But we thought it was going to be to get co-op support eventually. It didn't.
Yeah.
So this is the game we should have gotten then that, and I understand they were a small team at the time. They have a hell of a lot more support now. But we're going to have a four-player co-op zombie game that has legitimate, survival elements to it, that you build bases. Real scavenging, vehicles, weapons. It's mechanically wonderful. Like, I love that game because I found a goddamn broadsword. I literally went and found a crashed plane, pulled a sword out of the damn thing, and started hacking at zombies with it.
It was great. Yeah, I'm intrigued because it's State of Decay. I'm not interested in, hey, here's another zombie game like Sony showed us earlier. But because State of Decay is a great game.
It has a unique mechanical gameplay to it. Like, it feels really, really well done.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel loose or, without context. It has its own tight mechanical system to it. Honestly, if you took the zombies out and you put in something else, it'd be fine too.
Yeah. But I'm looking forward to State of Decay 2. We Happy Few. Holy shit.
Yeah.
I've heard a lot about that game for the past few years, for quite a while. It looks great. I know it's like a post dystopian, type of future.
Everyone was snarking about it being, trying to live a Bioshock or whatever. But it seemed to separate itself very well, even though it was the same kind of style.
Sure.
It was very much its own.
And, I think that's fine. Bioshock set a really good standard.
Oh, yeah.
And I would think that any game that strives to be like Bioshock...
I was going to say, in any game being compared to Bioshock right off the bat, that's fantastic for them. Because the fact that comes to people's minds. They showed off a what, the montage of indies randomly. They showed Cuphead in there, some more of the, wow, I already forgot the name of it. Wow. It's gone. Cuphead's really the only one that's really standing out to me. And how about yet?
Well, just looking at Cuphead, you know, and I was looking into the development of it. That game is took a lot of damn work to it.
They are working their asses off on it because it's like hand drawn animations. It's
like it has to be like all the frames and everything.
Yeah, that's insane. But
I still want it.
Oh yeah. Like, right. Like my hype is starting to wear down on it to where I'm just kind of like, come on, come out already. But I know that when it comes out, I'm gonna be fully like, fucking freaked about it.
Okay, and Halo Wars 2.
Halo Wars 2, yes. I hope they don't dumb down the PC version as far as control goes. That's cool. There's gonna be crossplay. I don't know how that's gonna work if they don't dumb down the PC. If you're playing against console players. Because they're at an inherent disadvantage. That's not bias or anything, that's just straight up fact.
Yep.
So it'll be interesting to see how they kind of balance it out.
Guess we'll see.
But it looks good.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. That trailer, I actually really liked it.
Yeah.
You know, you had both the commanders walking slowly towards one another
in the
while everything was going to hell around them.
It was a really cool trailer, and they followed it up with really cool gameplay.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's something I think we need to commend Microsoft for, was new footage, gameplay. Talk about it a bit. New footage, new gameplay, talk about it a bit. Next thing, next thing, next thing. They had amazing pacing.
Yeah.
They had great music numbers that went with every single game. It was legitimately, I would say, the best E3 of this year. Just the conference was so smooth.
Yeah, the most well put together one, yeah. I'm more hype about things that are coming in. I like Bethesda's and such, but yeah, it was the best well put together one.
You want let's talk about what they didn't show. Like Crackdown 3.
Crackdown 3. What the we got a third of a second of it. Like, that was one of the main things that I was excited to see about it. And nothing. Like, what? I'm so tired of the bait and switch about Crackdown 3.
That's like, not the only game we've been getting that crap with, though. I mean, look at EA, for God's sake.
Yeah, with the Mass Effect Andromeda stuff. Hey, look, here's some behind-the-scenes stuff, and you get no gameplay.
Man,
fuck you!
Oh, yeah, there was that new game that the creators of Limbo is making.
Which, I don't know, it seemed like another cinematic trailer, so why my mind skipped over it.
Yeah.
There's also Scalebound, too. I don't
know. Oh, yes, Scalebound. That looks awesome. It looks stupid, but I'm not saying that is a bad thing. It looks stupid, but super fun.
It looks like
I want to mention something.
Sunset Overdrive, honestly. Like, it's a Sunset Overdrive with...
I think that's going to work against it.
It's Sunset Monster Hunter.
Yeah, basically.
I want to mention something about that, though. The whole wearing a headphone thing and trying to act all edgy, I think is going to work against it. Like, we're working against it for me.
Yeah, like, for some reason they seem to be modeling this, like, at least the main character after New Dante. And it's just like, don't do that. That's the Hot Topic, Dante.
Oh, we have to mention the elephant in the room. Sea of Thieves.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. They showed actual legitimate gameplay footage.
And you can get drunk, and that's awesome.
You can actually destroy other players' ships. Make them sink.
Here's the thing that I had about that. I couldn't focus on the gameplay because of all the Let's Players like screaming and shit.
Yeah, I tuned that out the best I could.
Yeah, that was pretty cringy.
I couldn't tune it out. Like, why do the face cam and that kind of shit? Like, come on. And there was no discernible UI most of the time. So that worried me that it was still very doctored and scripted, which I'm sure what they were doing was scripted anyways. But, I mean, I'm very interested. And if what we saw is actually what we're going to get, awesome. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, but that cut off at the end before the ship collision, that was such bullshit.
Right? It's the same thing, like, I understand, like, why Bethesda did it last year with Doom, when, you know, he pulls out the fucking PFG, and right before it fires, boom, doom. But, like, this was, like, not as climactic and not enough of a payoff either.
Yeah. Tekken 7.
Oh, yes, I forgot about that. Looks good.
Although,
some of the stuff was underwhelming. Like, the finishers? Like, it seems like they're about to do something so insanely badass, and then it's just like, kick punch.
Yeah.
I'm surprised ReCore hasn't come up yet.
Oh, yeah, ReCore.
ReCore. They didn't show a lot. They showed a little bit of gameplay, so I'm happy about that.
We got to see platforming. Some puzzle section.
It seems like it's going to be your standard action-adventure game that we've come to see from the makers of Metroid Prime.
That is such a wide genre.
Yeah. Action-adventure platformer in the style of, like, ukulele or, you know, that kind of thing. But in its own, has its own mechanics, its own style. I'm very excited for it, but I need to see more of it.
Yeah, right now they really haven't shown enough to really form a, you know, informed opinion.
I think total gameplay we got was like 10, 15 seconds.
Still more than the A.
True. We saw that there's a double jump and dash forward mechanic, grapple. Yeah. We didn't see much else. We know that you're going to be able to switch the bodies. They showed some of the different classes of bodies, so that's interesting. You have the more, you know, attack-centric ones, the more utility ones. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays into the gameplay. Gameplay. What else?
The Gwent standalone.
Oh, yeah. I know there's definitely some people out there super excited for it. I don't care myself, but it's good for everyone who does.
Yay.
I'm pretty sure Joe got Judd.
Wait, what?
So I'm pretty sure Joe got Chubb.
Oh yeah, Joe was talking about it. So was Jesse Cox, because I know they were both huge fans of Gwent. Nothing about Cyberpunk 2077.
Yeah, that was really disappointing.
Like, damn. No, we got no Man's Sky. We got no Cyberpunk 2077. We got no Crackdown 3. We got
no Destiny.
No Destiny. We got
Kingdom Hearts 3. Star Ocean.
No Star Ocean.
No Shenmue.
Yeah, it's the list is probably all the stuff that we saw last year.
You know what? I want to go ahead and say it right now. We got no fucking Mass Effect either.
Yeah, we got that behind the scenes thing, but we got no Mass Effect.
We basically got like a lens flare trailer.
We got no visceral Star Wars. No.
No Star Wars.
No Respawn Star Wars. That behind the scenes video pissed me off, but that was EA's conference, so I'm not gonna talk about it. Yeah, there was more missing than was shown, I feel.
Which begs the question if they're probably gonna show more at later conferences, maybe QuakeCon, perhaps?
Well, yeah, QuakeCon, we're gonna see more of Quake, of course, and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And that there are other... What else?
I don't know, is there anything else?
We'll see more Infinite Warfare COD XP. I'm surprised we didn't see any multiplayer play, but... was there anything else for Xbox? The new controller. What are they calling it? Design Labs?
Yeah, Design Labs. Yeah.
That's really cool. The theme from last year and this year seems to be fuck you pro controller sites and fuck you custom controller sites. We're going to do it ourselves.
And they're doing the link in your chat to one I just like whipped up in 5 minutes.
Oh yeah, I've got one on my Twitter I whipped up too.
We haven't seen this yet because the show got cut off, but apparently Deus Ex Mankind Divided had some gameplay show up.
They did a full-on live stream. It was after Bethesda. But that was last night, and I was just like, I need to go to bed.
Yeah.
I got some of it later because they were doing a rerun of it on a different Twitch channel. It looks pretty great.
There's the Arma 3 Apex expansion.
Oh, yeah.
There's that. Didn't really see anything about it, but cool.
Yeah. Anything else come out of Xbox? I can't think of any for the life of me.
I think that was basically it.
That was pretty much it. So, all in all, a pretty underwhelming day for E3. Especially ending on a whimper like Sony's conference. What the fuck?
Yeah, that conference was just... I don't even know.
Well, I think we covered as much as we possibly could remember at this point. I'm pretty sure Jason's going to go back through for anything we missed. You know, comment on it.
I mean, I'll have to, but, yeah, if nothing else is coming to mind for anybody, I guess we can end it there. Thinking of anything else?
I think that's about it.
I've missed a few conferences due to
Final Fantasy 15. We didn't cover that, did we?
Oh, yeah. We got some gameplay. We got a launch date. It looks solid. They were dropping frames, but I'd rather see a stream that's dropping frames, or, you know, a gameplay that's dropping frames, than see, you know, the standard Ubisoft gimmick.
Yeah.
When is that coming out? I made a note of it. September 30th.
I do want to point out, though, that the guy who was actually playing that, he was pretty bad. He kept getting his ass kicked.
Oh, yeah. He was... I've got some comments from my video that I made while he was playing. They'll be in the supercut. So yeah, I guess we... Yeah, I can't think of anything else.
Yeah, I'm coming up empty too.
So much missing. But so yeah, that was it for our E3 coverage for, well, this year, I guess. Got here discussing it for the after show or whatever with me. We got Eiousx, Digsgambit, and would you rather I call you Mr. Cyborg or Outcast Cyborg? Either way.
Just call me Mr. Cyborg, it's fine.
But thank you guys for talking through this with me. Listening to my ramblings. Yeah. And thank you for everybody for coming out and watching me watch a show.
Well, to be fair, at times watching you watch the show was more entertaining than the show.
I mean, that's fair. So yeah, thank you everyone for coming out, and until next time, I'll stay sexy out there.